Hi guys, Frank here from Build Your Own. Today we're going to actually do a quick walk around review of my newly acquired 1994 Chevrolet Cheyenne C1500. This is actually my first truck and I'm super excited to have some fun with it and share my journey with you. So make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can follow along. And real quick before we actually get into this review, if you like trucks like I do, be sure to check out all the build and price reviews I've done of new trucks. I have a playlist. I have a complete playlist of all the trucks I've done. I'm going to go ahead and put a link to that playlist up in the corner right now. So this guy's is a 1994 Chevrolet Cheyenne C1500. It was a full-size pickup truck manufactured by General Motors. And really, it's just a trim level of the CK, all right, which was Chevrolet's full-size pickup truck line from October 1959 until 2002 in the United States. Truck looks pretty good. It's old, but it still looks pretty good. This whole time it's been running, it purrs like a kitten. So in 1994, three trim levels of the CK were available. This one, the Cheyenne, the Scottsdale, and the Silverado. Now the C and the K, what does that mean? The C means that the truck is a two-wheel drive, and the K means that it's a four-wheel drive. This is a C1500. That means it's a two-wheel drive truck. So in 1994, models received a new front fascia. There were federally mandated center high mount stop lamp. That's up here. I don't even know if this thing works. I've never even seen it turn on, but that's that federally mandated center mount stop lamp. I guess there was a whole bunch of new exterior colors, including a new two-tone option on the rocker panels and new tire and wheel combinations. This one here looks to be a work truck with very basic wheels, very basic interior, which we'll take a look at in a second. But yeah, there were other trim levels. This one is not one that was dressed out very highly. No, this is not the most attractive example of a 1994 Cheyenne C1500, but this thing purrs like a kitten. This engine's been running the whole time. It purrs in here. And speaking of engines, let's talk about engine options. What was available in 1994 on this CK line? Remember, because the Cheyenne is just a trim level. What was available on the CK line, the engines for 1994? There was this engine right here. This one's the V6. It's a 4.3 liter. It makes 160 horsepower. There was also a 5-liter V8 that made 175 horsepower. There was a 5.7 liter V8 that made 210 horsepower. And there was actually a 6.2 liter diesel V8 and also a 7.4 liter V8 that made 230 horsepower. That came in the 3/4 ton and 1 ton trucks only. As you can see, it's really plain in here. It was super dirty when I bought this car, but I cleaned it up a little bit. And you can see that it's very plain. And this is a work truck. I'm almost positive of it. And so let's talk about work trucks. The work truck was introduced in 1988. It featured a single cab, a long bed with Cheyenne trim, which this is, and a new grille with black bumpers. Now, this one has a black bumper on the back, but it does have a chrome bumper on the front. But this is a very old truck. Who knows where that bumper came from? This is probably the original bumper back there. That's probably not the original bumper up front. This sure does run very well, this vehicle. I'm really impressed. I paid so little for it, and it runs very well. Anyway, let's talk transmission and fuel economy. So this is a 1994 Chevy Cheyenne. It came with a 5-speed manual transmission. That was standard. But a 4-speed automatic overdrive was optional in all trim levels. This truck has that 4-speed automatic overdrive. The truck gets between 14 and 17 miles per gallon in the city, depending on the model, and between 19 and 22 miles to the gallon on the highway. The extended cab with 4-wheel drive and 8-foot bed gets the worst fuel economy at 14 city and 19 highway. This bed doesn't look bad back here. This looks to be a long bed. I would guess maybe the 8-foot bed. Bed's a little scratched up back here, but we'll put a plastic liner on there just like in the rest of it. Eventually we'll get something on there. But let's talk about dimensions while we're looking at the bed and looking and thinking about that. So the 1500, which this is, that's a half ton truck. The 2500 is the next level up. It's a 3/4 ton. And then you got the 3500, which is a 1 ton. Short bed trucks only come in 1500 series only. They rode on 117.5 inch wheelbase and had a 6.5 foot cargo bed. Long beds, which this one is, let me pan out so we can actually get it all in. Long beds, which this truck is, it came in all three series, whichever series you had, whatever trim level. It had a 131.5 inch wheelbase and yeah, an 8 foot bed. This truck has an 8 foot bed. If you had the extended cab pickup truck, it rode on 155.5 inch span with an 8 foot bed, or 141 inch with a 6.5 inch bed. Anti-lock rear brakes were standard. The base engine was this V6, but a broad range of V8s were available, including the diesel. We already covered all that, right? Yeah. Apparently there were sport side versions of this truck, but it only came in a short bed only. It had flared rear fenders. Those were, with regular fenders, were called fleet side. A 454 SS muscle truck arrived in 1990 with a performance handling package. Okay, so this thing's got a hitch on it, like most trucks do. That means it can tow. So if you're thinking about towing a trailer with a 1994 Chevrolet or GMC C1500 pickup, that means two-wheel drive, then it's important to know what your tow capacity is, all right? So based on the owner's manual and the internet, because I looked it all up, for this 1994 C1500 two-wheel drive with the 4.3 liter V6, your towing capacity is 5,500 pounds. When it came to towing capacity, I came across some other information on the internet. It said something about that it requires a 373 rear axle. I don't know if that's correct or not. That it requires a Z82 trailering special package, requires automatic transmission, requires an engine oil cooler, transmission oil cooler, weight distribution hitch, and a higher tow rating is listed for pickups that tow fifth wheel trailers, which I don't think a C1500 with two wheel drive would be rated for. Okay, so how does this vehicle run and drive? This vehicle is very old. It's a 1994. It's about 25 years old, this vehicle. How does it run and drive? It's got 206,000 miles. Yes, it purrs like a kitten, but how does it drive? Well, you know, I just purchased this car yesterday. I just purchased this vehicle yesterday. I've only had it for about 24 hours. I can say that it drives pretty good, actually. The steering is a little vague. So it could probably use some bushings and things like that, but it runs very, very well. Now, do note that this vehicle, this truck, is a replacement for a couple other vehicles that I did have on the channel that I no longer have. I had a Volvo S60 and a Mercury Grand Marquis on the channel. I'll put some links up to those videos in the corner right now. So actually, yesterday, in anticipation of purchasing this car, I recorded... I went to Craigslist because I found the car on Craigslist for sale, and I actually recorded, I did a little screen share of that ad and what the guy said and all that there. And honestly, he said it was a great running truck and that it was ugly, but it runs really good. And honestly, the guy was quite truthful. So I did do a little recording of that, and I actually recorded a short clip when I actually purchased the car from the guy's location. So let's flip to that real quick. Guys, it's Frank here with Bill Drone. You know what? I just bought this truck. It's got 206,000 miles on it. It's actually pretty straight. I'm gonna send a clip after we walk, do this little walk around of me looking at the ad on Craigslist and talking about it a little bit earlier. This thing purrs. It's got 206,000 miles on it. It is very nice. Bought it from an attorney. That's his Scout in the background. He was restoring that Scout. While, and so he was driving this to go to court and do it all that. Like I said, the guy's an attorney, super cool guy. Yeah, go check out the clip on Craigslist when I was looking at it this morning.
So I saw this vehicle on Craigslist the other day. It's a 1994 Chevrolet 1500 pickup. It's got a 6-cylinder. It's got 204,000 miles. This guy says that the truck runs great. It's got new tags. He used it while he restored his other car, and that project's done. He says this vehicle is ugly, but it runs great. It burns no oil. He said he'd drive it anywhere. He drove it for over a year with no problems. It's a farm work truck. He wants $1,100 or best to offer. This is exactly what I need. I no longer have my Marquis, so I need a good, dependable truck that maybe I can fix up and get around in, and maybe even make some money with. So yeah, let's take a look at this truck.
Okay, so what issues does this truck have? I mean, it's old, it's 25 years old. What issues does it have? Yeah, it's ugly. Yep, it needs some tires. Yes, it probably needs a wheel alignment and some suspension stuff. No, the AC does not work, but it purrs pretty good. It seems to be a little bit rough in the mornings, or when it sits for a while, it doesn't seem to have a high idle, but it sure does run very, very well. So yeah, I'm so far so good. I'm pretty happy with it. I probably will get the vehicle run through, get it checked out, get it tuned up, get the oil changed, things like that in the very near future. Speaking of future, what are my future plans? What do I want to do with this truck? You know, obviously it's just an old work truck. It's never gonna, you know, I'm not gonna restore it or anything like that. Actually, all I'd really like to do is I'd like to put a lift kit on this truck. I'd like to go through it, make sure all the systems are strong. The engine seems to be very healthy. Probably doesn't need much to make it purr like a kitten. I've done a lot of reading online. These engines, this V6 engines are strong. They can go over 300,000 miles. This engine's just over 200,000 miles. The guy's taking good care of it. It's evident. And so I just like to put a lift kit on it. I don't want to add any performance enhancers. I just want to make it a good running truck. Maybe put a stereo in there because it's got a horrible factory stereo system in there. Let's take a look at it real quick. I mean, what is that thing? I mean, seriously. I mean, that looks like that should be in kit car. You know what I'm saying? From like circa 1995. I mean, what is that? But it does have power locks and windows. There are the speakers right there. I think there's only, well, no, there's four. There's one there, and there's one in the there's two in the dash, and then one on each of those pillars, because there's one, you know, over here somewhere. Yeah, there it is. And so, yeah, the truck is, I need to get a brake pad thing on there for the, so my foot doesn't slip off when it starts raining. The turn signals, they do work, but, So it needs some stuff, but overall, it's a great truck. It's a good running truck. And like I said, it's been running this whole time. You don't see it smoking. You don't hear it overheating or nothing like that. It's purring like a kitten. It's a good running truck. I'm very, very, very happy with this truck. And it was a great buy. It was really a great buy. Maybe my best ever. Okay, guys, so here's the deal. I think we learned everything we needed to know about the 1994 Chevrolet Cheyenne, and specifically what I'm doing with mine. Not just the Cheyenne, really the CK, because this is a CK in the Cheyenne trim level. At any rate, if you found this walk around review helpful, informative, or entertaining, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the very next video.